Even though California is under a mega drought right now, they are warning of mega floods.
Yeah, and it's a big climate change thing about climate change. And because whenever you increase the heat, you increase how much these catastrophes are exaggerated. And with the all the fires burning, it's making perfect for landslides also. So when this flood does happen, which they're predicting from what is called atmospheric rivers, where large rivers of moisture in the air move and it stirs up things. And dude, I just think about weather control and DARPA. I thought about that too.
I thought about that too with this. It's like, they're using all these models to predict this.
All you need to do is create an atmospheric river. You don't have to shoot lasers and make fires. You need to create an atmospheric river. It will contrast with the dry air. We'll get insane rain. Everything's burned. It's perfect. There'll be landslides. Everyone will be fucked. And we'll ship them out of FEMA camps.
So what are atmospheric rivers? Atmospheric rivers are ribbons of water vapor that extend thousands of miles from the tropics to the western U.S. At 250 to 375 miles wide, they provide the fuel for the massive rain and snowstorms that can cause flooding along the west coast. It's like they're like hyper predicting this.
Yeah. They ran two simulations. ARC. Did you read about that? The simulations they ran, ARC, which they seemed pretty normal. Like, you should probably want to plan for that, but it was called like ARC storm scenario. And they're doing another one called that was in 2010 and another one called ARC storm 2.0.
Yeah.
Just running models of what would happen if a massive flood hit LA. And I mean, why would it not happen, dude?
So the two possibilities that they list for this are that, first of all, this happened back in 1862. And if this were to occur again, it would be $1 trillion in damage. Like if the same amount fell in the same areas. And that's the frequency of such a type of flood is, I don't know, once a century or something like that.
There's a 10-year, a 50, and a century.
Yeah.
Or a 10-year, a 20, and a 100-year.
So that's one of the things they blame on it. The second thing is they say is these atmospheric rivers that would cause it due to climate change are the two scenarios they propose in this article.
Yeah, and they use climate change and global warming a lot. Those two things are different. It also mentioned how I should find it. I mean, it pinpointed it on human created climate change, and I should have made a better note of where that was.
The researchers used new high resolution weather models and existing climate models to compare two extreme scenarios, according to UCLA. One that would occur about once a century in the historical climate of recent decades, which is what I was describing, and another in the projected climate of 2081 to 2100. Both would involve a long series of storms fueled by atmospheric rivers over the course of a month. So this is the projected climate of 2081 to 2100, based on, I guess, the current trends of climate change, which they, if I remember correctly, they've gotten wrong since the 80s. Like where they were predicting the climate would be in 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. Now our technology and shit for measuring that has probably gotten better over the course of the last couple of decades. I just think that the climate is such a complex model to predict. They have no idea what the projected climate is going to be in 2081 to 2100. So,
yeah. And I would encourage everybody to watch, Randall Carlson at the very beginning of one of his episodes with Rogan, because he shows a chart of climate change over the last 150,000 years. And it's based off of the deep inland Greenland ice sheet core sample. They didn't take a sample from the edge of the ice sheet where it melts and recedes and comes back and it's not fresh. They went to the deep where it's always frozen, and they got raw data back to, and the climate fluctuation is very regular, and we're within that regular fluctuation, but it's increasing. It's like a stock, right? You know, you're going up, but you're still within the range that it's been doing for the last 150,000 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then it shows hard ups and hard. That was way before fossil fuels, was way before all that. So the climate has a natural shift that is in these degrees, even more, way more, way, way, way more. And we're not even to the max that the average has been.
It has been in the past, yeah.
Yeah. And so this narrative that people are causing it by driving cars is totally false. We're right within the range that the climate fluctuates all the time. It's the hard peaks that are going to fuck us, and you can't blame it on cars, because there's also science. I'll just finish with this, that the amount of carbon dioxide that plants can process is way more than the amount that we're putting off from cars every year. So they have no problem processing that. It's really not us doing this.
Yeah. I think the argument could be made that even within the range of the graphs you're talking about that Randall presents at the beginning of that Rogan episode that shows the trends and we're on the upswing of one, could the argument be made that man-made CO2 emissions and things like that are causing these spikes to be more significant than in the past? Like, we're going to experience a spike in temperature anyway, right? But is human activity causing those spikes to be more extreme than they typically would have been? You know what I'm saying? Where temperatures are going, rising at a rate faster than what they would have done 10,000 years ago.
Maybe in a short term, like if you're
right in the short city, term, right? Like it's all relative city. Within the swing of the trends, but
it's hard to tell in the 150,000 year trend, because we're still maybe in the short, there'd be a peak in some areas where there's a lot of smog and there is gas and things. That's just my theory. I'm just talking. Just answering your question. I don't know.
No, I get it. Neither one of us are smart enough to answer that. I was just curious. I mean,
cars definitely make the air dirty, break dust. They're, you can measure that. But we're talking about the climate of the world and what's happening. Cars aren't making the ice caps melt. Climate changes, and it's a natural fluctuation. Until further notice, there's no reason to put it on people driving cars to the point where we got to pay a tax for it. Like,
yeah, fuck that. Go, you know, fuck yourself.
Allow me to resist that without being a fucking right-wing heretic over here. You know, we don't need to pay a tax. It ain't cars causing this. But there is, to wrap it up real quick, we got climate change, the first animal extinct in Australia. That's a virus from China.
First animal extinct. What are you talking about?
Sorry, there was another. It was the Bramble K. melamus climate change ravaged rodent listed as extinct, an Australian rodent that went extinct. It was basically a rat in Australia. So nothing really to cover there, but it was something I found. But I think the last article we have is the Langya virus in China, right?
You heard it here first, folks. Before,
I don't think it's going to be a big deal. It's just transmitting between animals. There's no transmission between humans yet.
Well, humans have caught it, but there's no transmission from human to human at this point.
Langya Hinepa virus lady was found in 35 patients in the Shandong and Henan provinces.
He's racist.
Fever, fatigue, and cough. Dude, Shandong, I pronounced it right. Shandong and Henan.
No, you're like, Shandong.
I just pronounced it, dude. I just pronounced it the way it is.
Yeah, you put a little Asian twang on that voice. Racist motherfucker.
Dude, I'm just reading the way the words are, man.
Yeah, you're like, well, it was found in 35 patients in the Shandong and Henan provinces.
I'm sure if people are listening in China, they appreciate it. Like, they know what I'm talking about.